a pleasure to be here in the Xenia Fair. It's my second time in this kind of event is in Greece. And I thank you very much, my colleague and professor, Professor Tomatazzo. And would you like to say hello also to Professor Helen Tatler, which is the director of the design department in the university here in Athens, so thank you. But above all, my greetings for the support to the sponsor, Kypriotis, which has a stand here in Xenia. And then I would like to thank also Xenia Fair and also the president of Xenia Fair, Mr. Yalouris, for hosting this kind of event and conference. I think that is very important for me, and it's a pleasure to stress this idea about the Italian approach in hotel design. We can go on, and we can go next slide. I am Francesco Sculica, and I work mainly in Politecnico di Milano. And in Politecnico, there is the design system, which consists of the Department of Design, where we develop research activities, the School of Design, where we teach design, and I teach interior design. And then we have a polydesign, which is sort of link between the professional world and the academic world. And here, in this case, I am as I have the head of a polydesign in a way consultants, because polydesign take care also about the relations with the fair events and professional consultancies. We did some in professional consultancies, some activities for hotel chains, brands, and also we write and published some books, essays, articles in this field. And for example, this was a sort of a commitment for an hotel, and not an hotel chain, an office brand, which wanted to, in a way, to test the hospitality field. So we designed some special guest rooms that they have been exhibited in Las Vegas International Fair, which is one of the most important worldwide hospitality fair and event. Here is my team, which I coordinate in Politecnico, in research, teaching, and also consultancy professors. So we are a group of young professors, researchers, and also professionals in this field. So what are our fields? We take care about strategic design, research activities, concept development, workshops and lecture, conference and roundtables, and study tours and on-demand courses. These in relation to the School of Design, the Department of Design, and Polydesign. And the Italian approach, I want to test, in a way, I want to stress this my experience in this field. The Italian approach here, I selected some key words with some texts, which wanted to highlight the what are the best elements which featured the Italian approach, the relevance of the context, of course, the relevance of the place, the relation with the history, the natural landscapes and panorama, research, of course. We want to go on, to go over the stereotypes connected to the hotel formats, the hotel typologies, but also the interior design formats. Then we, of course, humanity. Human being is the center of our attention, as I think this is very, very important, and details. Ludwig Mies van der Rohe, which was a famous architect, used to say that God is in the details. And I think that this is especially true in Italian design approach. We take care about the little things. We take care about the details of things, because we think that through the details we can give a global sense, to a global meaning to all the result. Context influence, here you see how often we work, we have a fantastic, but as in Greece, we have a lot of parallelism of relations between Greek culture, Greek landscape, and Italian culture, Italian landscape. So landscape, for example, is a sort of big inspiration for hospitality structures. and Italian dimensions of hospitality structure as well. We have little hotels, not so big, between 30, 35 rooms and 150 rooms, not more. Biggest hotels are exceptions, I have to say. So also this is true, this is stress, the idea that the quality is in the details. The quality of Italian approach is the small scale, the small dimensions. And the luxury is quality. I think that this is specific of Italian approach. Now in hospitality design, I have to say that the last research showed that what is very interesting today is the attention of hospitality chains, but also design offices, etc., to the luxury dimensions, which is very, very important. But we have to say that we have an idea of luxury, which is different from other culture, for example, because we believe that luxury is a sort, is a question of quality, general quality, for shaping, for technological, for sustainability, and not is a way to express the powerful, the richness. No, it's something which is connected to elegance. And elegance comes from the Latin verb eligere. Eligere, it seems to select, to put it away. So to leave the essential things, which is completely different from the traditional idea of luxury. And I think that this definition well represents the idea of Italian luxury. Of course, sustainability is one of the most important topics, and I think today also you discussed, you have just discussed about this main topic about sustainability also in Italy, and there are quite a good examples in hotel design field which stress this idea of sustainability and also biophilic design, so the relation with the nature, which is becoming more and more important in hotel design approach. And this is my personal vision. I think that each hotel is a sort of is a sort of way to read the countryside or the humor surrounding the context. So it's a sort of the hotel designer and architects are a sort of translators. I use this quote by a famous architect, which has been Luca Scacchetti, which was a great architect in hotel design. And he say, each architect and designer is a translator of the values of the countryside, of the context, of the urban surrounding, and so on. And here we say, of course, you know, the hotel is something very, which is the design and the management of hotel is something very, very, very difficult to manage, to develop. And I think that there are a lot of parameters which stress this idea. And above all, I stress two elements which today are more and more important, the experience for the guests and also the general atmosphere. And these two elements are each other related. Of course, another important theoretical approach is based on this relation between space, products, and service in a relation to provide a special experience for the users, for the guests. And this is, I think, something which is really, really important if you want to manage the design, the hotel design approach in a good way. But you have also today, you have to, when to design an hotel, but also when you manage an hotel, you have to consider that we have three different ways of experience the hotel interior, the hotel in a way, because there is a booking, a first phase, which is the booking phase, where you come in touch in a virtual dimension, through a virtual dimension with the website, with the social media and so on. So you start to know the hotel before to go into the hotel. But it's something that you have to design as well. Then there is, of course, the stay. But it's different from the past because you have just an idea. So you check your idea that you had through the social and the website with the reality. And then, of course, after, when you go away, The hotel tried to develop loyalty programs, a survey, in order to make a fidelization, a relation with the guest after its or his or her staying. And I think this is very, very important when you have to design an hotel, but also when you have to manage an hotel. So here I did a selection of some case studies which belongs to, which shows in a way some trends in Italian hospitality, in Italian hotel design, and are of course is a personal selection. It's a personal selection based on research activities and on teaching activity as well. It's not a relation which is conditioned by some specific factors. I would like to stress an archetype. I start always my presentation on hospitality design about Joe Ponti, Hotel Parco dei Principi. Probably most of you well know this hotel. It has been placed in the Amalfi Coast. It was realized, designed and realized in the early 60s by Joe Ponti. It was the first design hotel or the first brand hotel. It doesn't exist any brand here at this time, but Ponti, which was an extraordinary architect, thinks to an ideal brand, the Amalfi Coast, with his natural surrounding and natural atmospheres, in order to create a fantastic space where to experience the context, the features of this fantastic space. And here, the interior, you see that it uses only two colors, the light, the blue of the sky, of the sea, and the white of the light, the natural light, and he applied it to a fantastic series of ceramic tiles and rocks, from also produced by the Vietri firms, which is an historical firms in these fields. So he creates a sort of an experiential path through a series of steps in relation to this atmosphere. He designed everything. It's a total design approach from the swimming pool to the lobby, to the bar, to the restaurant. And also in the restaurant, he designed the tablecloths and the table sets, and study also a special risotto, a special dish with the chef of the Parco dei Principi, which was colored with the methylene, which was an innocuous chemical colorant, in order to emphasize the experience, this chromatic experience for the guest. So it was really an innovation. We are in 1962, so many years before other designers, as the French ones or other Italians and so on, which stress the idea of the experiential design in hotel spaces. And here also masterpiece, the furniture for the guest room. The guest room are designed using the same kind of furniture that produced by Cassina. Cassina was a famous brand. And they are all in the same, in the room, there are the same furniture. But in each room, there is a different different pavement with a different decorative pattern using decorative elements, but using the two colors of white and blue. Here you see a combination of a mix of these colors and these kind of patterns. I think that this is a masterpiece. It has been restored recently, and it's not a museum. You can use as an hotel, and it's very contemporary in a way. Many people from all over the world, they used to go, they go to this hotel in order to live this experience in Ponti world, but also in this special context. Then we see some trends in relation to Italian approach in design hotel. Of course, they show hotels which belongs to the high-standing ones, so they are luxury, because luxury is more and more important today in Italy for hotel. As I discussed with some of you today, when you want a middle hotel in Italy, you choose an Airbnb or a bed and breakfast. If you want an hotel, you choose a luxury one. So there are a lot of also foreign enterprises, hotel chains, and so on, which are invest a lot of money in the realization of hotels, mainly in Milano from 2015 is one of the places where you have more hotels, but also Rome now is becoming very, very important for new hotels. The Bulgari is the last one. I think it's very, very important. Is the last hotel which the Bulgari brand realized in Rome after having realized almost 10 hotels from over the world, from Milano to Bali to Shanghai to Beijing to Dubai to London and so to Moscow and so on. They want to come back to Rome because Rome is the town where the Bulgari brand was born. The Bulgari brand is one of the most important brands in luxury jewelries and also fashion accessories and fashion, we have to say. They want to celebrate the relation with the city with Rome and its classic history. So he chose to open this extraordinary hotel in an old 30 years building they restored because it was near Mausoleo di Adriano, this archaeological report which celebrated the Roman Emperor Augusto, and so it's a sort of a tribute to the classic way of seeing Rome and its history. This is as in each Bulgari, strategic is this relation between the Bulgari hotel and resorts, of course, but then they call always ACPV architects, Antonio Citteri and Patricia Viel, to give an interpretation of Bulgari brands in the different locations. And there they always did a joint venture, a partnership with the famous international chain in luxury field, because to manage an hotel is not simple. So in a way, it's very interesting because they speak each other. They were in relation in this kind of operation and they apply the result to these classic buildings of the 30s years of the 20th centuries near the Maison Bulgari in Via Condotti. So it is a strategic position. We have to say that through this relation and through also the rule of and the ability of ACPV architects, they have developed almost 10 hotels, but you recognize it as hotel by Bulgari, but they are always different. So it's very, very interesting, this, because it's not a traditional hotel chain operation. It's something very special. In each concept for the Bulgari hotel, they quote, there are three elements always which featured each concept in each Bulgaris. The first is the relevance of design, developed by Citteri and Viel, is always a timeless design, is not too fashionable, is, I think, a classic modern design, which want to dialogue with the context, with the place, and with the cultural values of the place in which the hotel is placed. The food and the food design is also another important element, and the spa and wellness area, because the spa and wellness area, above all in luxury fields, are more and more important. So in each of the Bulgari, there is a wellness and spa area, which is really important. Here you see the Bulgari Rome. In the entrance, you see an archaeological report, is a statue of a Roman emperor, which comes from the famous Torlonia collection, which is one of the famous collection of archaeological Roman reports, which in a way welcome you on board, in a way, in the entrance of the Bulgari resort. And so you see in the Bulgari hotel, and so you see also the use of the marbles, which belongs to the Roman tradition, to the Roman cultures, and also, but they are applied looking to a modern way with these doors, which are very rigorous according to Antonio Citterio and Patricia Vieira style. These are some interiors which are not too fashionable, the modern design, but also, according to me, the 30s Art Deco design for some details, with also some elements like this lamp, the Atollo by Vico Magistretti, is an iconic design object coming from Italian design, which wants to stress sometimes the value of the space. And however, here, for example, is very interesting, and it's something which reveals our way of approaching the luxury, which is it's a cozy environment. It's not too emphasizes to reach is something in which the quality and the richness is perceived through the use of materials, the use of details, the richness of the surface, and the contrast between the different colors or the precious elements like the marbles which have used in these interiors. This is fantastic elements. I think it's a special one in Bulgari. Rome is a library, because in the Roman palazzi and in many Roman palaces, and many Italian palaces, library have been so important. So you think to the Leopardi Palace, for example, in Recanati, where the library have been so important. And here they want to celebrate this relation with the culture, because they say what important in luxury is always to relate a relation, to emphasize this relation with the culture. And here you see the fantastic spa. We see that in each Bulgari, the spa is a fantastic place. And this is a little bit different from the other interiors we see that are a little bit more simple, more rigorous. This is inspired to the famous terms of Caracalla terms, which during the Roman Empire, the spa and wellness place have been so important in social life, so they want to reintroduce this idea, but also with a sort of a neo-baroque approach, using all these columns recovered by marbles. And then you see these perspectives towards the hand of this swimming pool with this fantastic and dramatic mosaic, which wanted to stress the value of the Bulgari and luxury field. And here you see always in Bulgari, but also not here, in many others, you see how the rooms, also the standard one, are thought as a suite. So it seems bigger than they really dimension. They are place to rest. They are some calm place, because today the time to having time is a really luxury. So they want to give you a special time where you can, a special place in which you can enjoy your free time, and you can relax. You can relax in the guest room and as well as relax in the bathrooms. Bathrooms are always, also in the little rooms, they are very well studied spaces. Here you see another suite, for example, also. Here you see this kind of domestic language, domestic approach. They want to stress this idea to feel you at home, to stay comfortable with yourself and with your relatives or with your friends. And always they stress the value of Italian design with these two, the Atollo lamp, as we have just seen in another space, but also the Castiglioni arch designed for Floss in the late 60s. And also This is a presidential bathroom, so with the use of marble. And also we see how in the hotel design today, other secondary space as the wardrobe becomes spaces of interest and of experimentation. That is a new lifestyle, a sustainable approach, a new trends, which is more and more important, I have to say. And these are two masterpieces, I have to say, in Italy today. Casa di Langa by Gas Studio and Paris Hotel Formenton and Marriott Venice, designed by Matteo Thun. Matteo Thun is one of the architects which starts since the beginning, since many years, to put in relevance the relevance of sustainability in hotel design approach. His first hotel, one of his first sustainable approach was the Virgilius Monte Resorts in the Alps, and it has been considered as one of the most sustainable hotel, or the first sustainable hotel in the world. Here we see Casa di Langa. You see, we pass from a language, Bulgari language, to another language. They want, Gas Studio want to give to the, in this hotel a sort of to create, is very recently it has been designed after, during the COVID. So also is an hotel which try to answer to the post-COVID way of staying and living the experience, and they want to design a space in which the sustainability create a new languages through the use of classic and also natural materials and through the relation with the context and the countryside. In fact, the hotel is inspired to a traditional Italian borgo. And it's in Piemonte region, so it's in a very green area, and has been designed in order also to minimize the use of air condition. So there are a sort of a relation between the different spaces which avoid, which try to minimize the use of technology for climatization. Here, other examples. The relation is very strong with the countryside, with the context, through the use of stones, of simple, of a design which is really simple, but is very sophisticated, through the use of the bricks, which bring us to the traditional elements of the farmhouses, which featured the Lange region, where this context is placed. Here, other pictures about the rooms, which shows this idea of sustainable Italian luxury. Of course, is luxury hotels, but with a more simple and refined element compared to other hotels. And this is another hotel, a special one, designed by Matteo Thun for the Marriott International chain. It's an island in the Venice Lagoon, and it designed this hotel maintaining all the existing buildings and structures without demolishing anything in order to approach this project in a sustainable way. Before it was an hospital, but so he created a big hotel in the building in which was the original hospital, and then you can go to this hotel by sea by the lagoon, and this give to this hotel a sort of exclusivity, because you can reach it only by boat or by helicopters if you have one. And this is also show, these two pictures are very, very important, because you see this distinction. It's clear, it shows the approach, the design approach of Matteo Thun to the box in the box. It builds inside the old buildings, the bricks, you see, the old ones. Inside, he built the new buildings in order not to demolish it, but using prefabricated elements in order to make a more sustainable realization. And this is projects, in a way, is applied in many other parts of the hotel. Then you see here, he used a very, very classic style. In a way, it's similar to the Bulgari approach, but maybe less glamour, using some colors and textiles or shapes which are inspired by the colors of the lagoon, the Venetian lagoon, the green and the pale yellow, the pale blue, for example. Or also he designed some glasses which produced by an old Barovieto Oso, which is an old firm and traditional firm in the Venetian context. And this is a suite, for example. This is a spa, and this was the old church. It was has been refurbished and used for events, meeting, congress, and so on. And here I have inserted this example because I want to stress this approach. Giorgio Armani Mari, Armani Design Studio, is something which is not an hotel, but the seaside and the beach are really important, also in Greece, in relation with hotel design and with hospitality design. Armani, Giorgio Armani, and its interior design division, they invent this way to approach and to look to the seaside in another way. So they study the seaside as place where to sell the brand, the products of the brands, and also to support the values of the brands. So in a way, is something which make the beach, the traditional seaside, as something more special in relation to the tourism, more fashionable. Also, is a process in which is an hybridization between retail store, entertainment and lounge place, restaurant places, fitness and wellness area, in a glamour to stress this glamorous experience. And this, for example, you see a relation between the products of the brands and some places of in these new seaside places, new beaches, where there are some old cabins which has been refurbished in shopping retails corners. Here we see a place in Laguna di Venezia, and it's a sort of a travel. Giorgio Armani designed this from Portofino to also Forte dei Marmi until to Capri until Venice. So it's an ideal world. And there is a difference, for example, with the Bulgari one. It's a brand extension process, which is really important today in Italian design approach. But in Bulgari, they call an external design office, which was Antonio Citteri and Patricia Viele. Here instead, Armani designed everything, because Armani inside his brand has a special division which take care, because Armani has a lot of strong passion since he was young. In fact, he starts his career as a window designer for La Rinascente. So interior design for Armani is very, very important. Ornament is not a crime. If we look to the Italian design, usually we think to something very rationalist, rigorous, classical, in relation to the example which we have seen until now. But I want to show this as a sort of exception. This is a Chateau Montfort, is a urban chateau, belonging to a little hotel chain in the center of Milano. And it's a place where there is a decorative and a fantastic approach to the world of interiors, looking to the old atmospheres of chateaus, but in a same time matching this atmosphere with contemporary references to the operas world. Milano is very famous for the operas, or also TV series by Netflix, for example. So, in a way, according to a postmodern approach. In fact, I have to say that the designers of this space were not architects and designers, but they were set designers, two scenographies, and they created this fantastic atmosphere. They restored this old palace in the center of Milano, Palazzo Mezzanotte, designed by a famous architect at the beginning of the 20th century. But then they use this more creative and fantastic approach. For example, you see here, through the use of colors, they give a sort of new interpretation of which is a traditional lobby lounge. Also, the dining room is a traditional. It looks to the past, but with a more imaginative and decorative vision. And also, there are many typologies of room, and some of these rooms are devoted to operas, for example, or to flowers, for example. This is The Firebirds by Tchaikovsky, is devoted to the famous operas The Firebird, and this is devoted to the hibiscus, but also looking to the Madama Butterfly experience, to the old Japan experience. And here, for example, we see to the contemporary inspirations. This is a room devoted to the famous Netflix series, The Bridgerton, which wants to stress this relation with the old English houses at the beginning of the 19th century. And this, for example, this is an old another room inspired by another opera by another ballet, Lo Schiaccianoci, by Tchaikovsky. And these are the main rooms. Most of the rooms are equipped in this way, devoted to the traveler room, it has been called. So the idea is that all the elements, all the decoration of this room comes out from a truck. And then it combines the decoration and the design of this room. This is really important today. We have seen how the food is very, very important in tourism and in hospitality and in hotel design. And above all, in Italy, we have a long tradition, but also in Greece, in many other countries, you have these strong traditions with the food. So this is a new little resort, only six rooms, placed in the center of Italy, near Naples. And it's a sort of joint venture between Cannavacciuolo brand, which is Cannavacciuolo is a famous chef in the contemporary design cooking, and hotel design. So there was this relation between, of course, to design a sort of little resort in the middle of a countryside. You see here the cultivations for the products in order to provide the needs for the restaurants and for the food. You see here how the outdoor space are more and more important. So what we need today is to stay outside after the COVID. We feel this need, and we feel also, and you see how to live the relation with the Italian countryside, which is typical spaces, which shows the relation with these typical spaces in the countryside of the center of Italy. And here, instead, the contrast is the interior. The interior is not vernacular, is not stylistic, but is a very, very contemporary design one. It's very different from the Bulgari also. It's a very rigorous, but a very modern and contemporary design language with using materials of the place, so according to a sustainable approach, like, for example, the kind of stones, the kind of bricks, and so on, but also using some materials as iron and steel, which belongs to the modern and contemporary language. And here you see a suite, which is really, there are only 6 rooms. It's really, it's a loft in the middle of the countryside, of Italian countryside. So there is this strong relation between interior and exterior. And bathroom, of course, are spaces which, as in Bulgaria, as we have seen in many other hotels, are more and more important. Adaptive reuse of buildings. Here we see 3 case studies which shows a different attitude to modulate the relation between an hotel design approach in contemporary way and the historic scenario. The first one is Palazzo Portinari in Florence by Spagnuolo and Partners. And this is a very a sort of Spagnuolo want to do to create a sort of immersive experience in the history of this building, which has been built during the Renaissance. Portrait by Michele De Luca and Michele Bonanno, we have 2 different approach because it's a urban design with the design of a square in a way, but also we have a fantastic new hotel design, a boutique hotel designed by Michele Bonanno for Lungarno Collection and for the Ferragamo brands. And then Palazzo Tirso by Marco Piva in Cagliari wanted to stress the relation between an old building of the first decades of 20th centuries and the technology and contemporary time. So here we see Portinari, and you see how he maintains the features of these fantastic environments, of these fantastic spaces, and this reveals also in Italian design the relevance to be able to dialogue with also carpenters, engineerings, restorations, restores, and so on. But also it reveals how in Italy, and for the importance of Italian design, it's important also to have all these kind of person which can support you in the development of this project. It's not a traditional hotel, but it's a series of different suites and apartments. So the common areas are limited because it express a contemporary idea of luxury where people want to stay alone and to live in suite and apartments and to have a few occasions, few opportunities to relate each other. Opposite to the tradition of the luxury grand hotels, where we have a big living room, big restaurants, and so on. This is another idea. And you see these, you see how technologies is full of technologies because it's not also here as in many other Italian hotels placed in historical sites. You don't want to stay in a museum. You want to have technological services. And so there is invisible technologies, but in this sort of immersive experience in the past. But for example, of course, he provides Spagnuolo to give some comfort using also some elements as sofa, beds, and other equipments and other accessories, which of course are support the comfort for the contemporary travelers. Lighting is also very important. Lighting design is also very important, and also which is in relation to the domotic system of the hotel. This is the portrait, and here we see, it was a sort of a big area in the center of Milano near the Quadrilatero della Moda, so near Via Monte Napoleone, Via del Gesù, in the fashion district of Milano. There was this old seminar built between the end of the Renaissance and the Baroque time, and it has used for many things, but then they closed for years. And they started the Ferragamo, the Lungarno Collection, by this area, and Michele De Lucchi restore this courtyard and give this new square to the town. So this is very important from a social point of view because connect a luxury interview, a luxury kind of refurbishment to the general urban surroundings is more democratic than other cases of in the fashion systems. So here, through a series of passages, you can go and in many other places in Milano, in the center of Milano. Inside this, you have the portrait which belongs to the Ferragamo family and all many of the Lungarno Collection hotels have been designed by Michele Bonan. Michele Bonan has an approach which is different from the Bulgari one or from the other designers. In a way, it looks to the retail and to the fashion system. In a way, it has a more decorative approach and it looks as in the guest room to the 50s year for the use of the colors, for example, for the use of textiles, for the kind of textiles as well, because the 50s year are the wonderful time, the golden time for Ferragamo, but also for the Italian fashion design, which becomes famous over the world. You see, these are typically these two bedside table lamps belongs, they looks to the traditional lamps, to the traditional abat-jour of the 50 years. And this is Palazzo Tirso in Cagliari by Marco Piva. Marco Piva is has a very famous office also in Milano, but also in many other parts of Italy. And the Palazzo Tirso, here you see a contrast because he wants to take inspiration by the materials, marbles and also granites. And also he took inspirations by the colors of Sardinia and also some shapes as these stools are typically, they in a way, they take inspiration by some archetypes in Sardinia countryside and so on. But the imaging, the realization, the result is totally contemporary. In fact, Marco Piva wanted to stress a sort of global design approach, which in a way reveal its Italian roots, but being in relation to a contemporary lifestyle and language. Here you see others, for example, other picture which shows sort of this contrast between the eclectic building and the interior design. And then the rooms, which perhaps I think that they are very interesting because there is this studying the traditional typology of hotel furniture according to different way. Look to this bedside to this part of the bed and also the relation with the textile, with the lamps and so on. And he used, as many hotel designers, he used hotels as an ideal place where to experiment new products which will be sold in a wide market. So I think also you see these some kind of objects which in a way also in this case reveals the relation with Sardinia typical shapes and art masterpiece. And this is the suite, fantastic. He used also here as a Citterio in the Bulgari. Piva used this sofa is produced by Cassina. This lamp is produced by Floss. So there is this co-branding activity, which often featured this kind of operation in order to emphasize the value of these hotel interiors. And here, this is a trend, is very, very important in Italy now. Until some years ago, we didn't have a rooftop in our hotels because we don't have these, only some hotels, for example, the Villa Medici, Hassler Villa Medici in Rome, or the Hilton in Monte Mario, or others have a rooftop. Now they understand the value of this space in which you can reinvent a relation with the town or with the surrounding space. And I think this is very true. Or also you can add, you can have some space more respect to the dimensions of the building in which you place some activities in relation to wellness, to well-being, to entertainment, to restaurant, to have breakfast, and so on. And this is the last one, the Blue Lagoon. Blue Lagoon is an hotel which has been placed, has been realized in the north, in Iceland, and by Basalt Architects, and a studio which is not in Italian, but the interior design have been developed by Design Group Italia and through the partnership with the two relevant brands, which are B&B Italia and Iguzzini for the lighting systems. Here you see this wonderful, the lagoon, the Blue Lagoon is a wellness spa destination properly, and it's a very organic architecture in related to a natural surrounding and to a fantastic lagoon. Here you can see how the architecture from Basalt study belongs to express this concept of an organic approach, but through using a contemporary and technology language. And also the interiors designed by Design Group Italian. I think that these are contemporary interiors for technologies, for languages, and so on, but they reveal the aim of the place in which this hotel is placed. So, for example, you look through these colors, through this use of a lighting system, you show that you are not in Italy in a way. You are in the north of Europe, as well as in the reception desk, with these kind of stones put into evidence in a very strong way. It evidence that you are in a Nordic context. Some other spaces. Here we have some furniture design customized for the hotels, beside some others which belongs to the historic collection of B&B Italia and also Iguzzini. Here we see two restaurants. One is a typical Nordish one with a very cozy atmosphere, and the other is more open to the outside through big windows. And you see how technology is important also in the studying of a specific lighting design system, as this big lamp designed for by Design Group Italia for Iguzzini. Fantastic relation through interior and exterior. This is a suite in which you see through these fantastic windows, these nice windows, the relation with the space around you, and also these are elements which belongs to the B&B Italia collections. Instead, others are customized elements, furnitures for the specific hotel. And the spa. The spa is fantastic. It's a sort of experience, of course, and it's very different from the spa that we have seen for the Bulgari, for example. But he wants to stress this personal relation with a sort of wellness experience through the use also of high technology and also using lighting and in the LED, for example, in the featuring of some parts. This is in order to conclude. I think that the time is gone because it's 3 o'clock and fast. I show you some research and design consultancy we do for this is we design a suite recently. These are some recently work we developed in Politecnico. This is a suite which we are going to realize, and it's a match between Rimini and Havana, and so two different places. And we want also to have a sustainable approach to through the application of the second life process. So we use reused elements, furniture, technologies, materials, and so on, in order to stress the second life trends. here we see this is I am very proud about this result. As Politecnico, we have been invited to an international competition among tourist and hospitality schools in the field of sustainable hospitality. It was a sustainable hospitality challenge, and our Polimi design group was the winner of this competition, and they create this sort of floating resort, sustainable resort, which we hope it has been will be realized in Neon, which is the new sustainable town which is going to realize in the Arabic Peninsula. Another disease we are working, next Tuesday I'm going to see the results of the students' work. So it's we are working in Sondrio. Sondrio is on the Alps, and is this is an old convent, so it's a refurbishment work. We wanted to transform this fantastic place in a sort of new hospitality structure. We are on the Alps, and so this is also in relation to another network in which I am involved, that is related to Milano Cortina 2026, the Winter Games. I am part of the scientific committee which take care about some events in the field of hospitality for the Winter Games. And here I want to quote the New Age is the Hospitality Industry Network, because I am part of the board of directors as a representative of the university wards, and I take care about scholarships. New Age was born in the 80s in the United States. It's a network association between hotel chains, hotel professionals, consultancy, brands, which dialogues with hospitality worlds. And before the pandemic, we create the chapter in Milano and in Italy. And I am part of the chapter, and I promote the relations and the networking about New Age. I would like to conclude my dissertation with this sentence, which I think it's very important, by Paul Bowles in 1949, so many years ago. He said he did not consider himself a tourist, but a traveler, and explained that this is partially a difference in time. After a few weeks or a few months, the tourist hurries home. The traveler, who does not belong to any particular place, moves slowly from one point on earth to another for years. I thank you very much.